friends, and welcome to NAC Graphics. We are going to discuss almost everything about the artboard. In simple words, artboard is a place where you draw. The gray area behind the artboard is called the pasteboard or the canvas. And you can keep all the waste or to be used later things or the artworks right here. Remember that things on the canvas will not get printed. Okay, now let's learn about the artboard in detail. After creating a new document, you enter the world of the Illustrator with your artboards. But what if you want to change the document settings like size or anything which you initially set while creating a new document? Like if you initially set the document size to be 800 by 600 and in the middle of the work you came to know that you actually need 1200 by 800 size. So here's what you do. You go to the file menu and there you have the document setup command. And that will take you to the document setup dialog box. We have two headings here. One is general and other is type. For now, we will discuss only this part because I'll cover all other things in future lessons. The first thing here is units. Here you can change the unit of measure for your document. Like if you have initially set the unit of measure to be the points and now you want to change it to inches, you can do it right here. Now, leaving all the things below to be learned in future, we will proceed to edit artboard button. Press this button and notice the change in working environment. You have dashed outline on the border of the artboard and control panel options related to artboard editing appear. Just for the matter of the fact, I should tell you that all the things appearing here are not global, which means it will be applicable to the selected artboard only. The first thing here is the presets. Under this option, you find a variety of presets of artboard size. As you notice, these presets are categorized under the profiles of print, web, devices, and video and film, and many more. If you remember, these are the same profiles what we saw while creating a new document. Bottom line, you can change your existing preset to any of these presets. On the top of the options of presets, you have two special options. First is Fit to Artwork Bounds, which means that your artboard will get shrunk up to the outer bounds of your artwork. The boundary of the artboard will cover every piece of artwork drawn by you. Let me show you with an example. I'm going to draw two random artworks. If you are new to Illustrator and following the series of my lessons, don't bother about how I drew these shapes, because you have exclusive coverage of this topic in the forthcoming series of lessons. So I have drawn two rectangles here, and if I want to shrink the artboard size up to the boundary of these shapes, I will go to the document setup, edit artboards, and in the presets, I will choose this option. And you see, the artboard is shrunk to the boundary of artworks. The second option is fit to the selected art, which means that your artboard will get shrunk up to the outer bounds of your selected artwork. Like if I select this rectangle only, and then select this option, the artboard will get shrunk to the boundary of the selected artwork. The next two buttons are for changing the orientation of your artboard, that is portrait or the landscape. Third button is for creating a new artboard. After pressing this button, a floating artboard will appear with your mouse pointer. Place it wherever you want on the canvas. Notice that it will be having the same size as was shown in the presets, or I should say, the size of the last artboard selected. Fourth button is for deleting the selected artboard. Notice that this button will be dimmed if you have only one artboard in your document. As you create more than one artboard, like I have created right now, this button will appear. Along with that, you have a little cross on the upper right corner of the artboard for deleting the artboard. The next thing is the name. Here you will enter a desired name of your selected artboard. However, Illustrator automatically gives a name to the artboard in an ascending numeric order. For example, I'm creating new artboards and it is naming as Artboard 1, Artboard 2, and so on. But you can change this name by the name you want by writing right here. Notice that Illustrator also gives an auto number to every artboard. This number appears on the left side of the name. This auto numbering has its own importance, which we will be discussing in the forthcoming lessons related to the artboard. Next to the name, we have four buttons. The first button is Move Copy the Artwork with the Artboard. This means that when you move or copy an artboard, all the artwork which is contained by that artboard will also get moved or copied. Like in case of this artboard containing two rectangles. If this option is enabled, and if I move the artboard, the artwork also moves accordingly and remain stick to it. But if I disable it and then move the artboard, the artwork is not gonna move. Second button is Show Center Mark, and it will mark a spot right at the center of the artboard. Third button is Show Crosshair, and it will mark a crosshair at the center point of horizontal and vertical borders of the artboard. The fourth button is Show Video Safe Area. Now, it is used for making a video safe area, and you may be wondering, what is this? So we will be covering this topic in future lessons. Now, these three buttons are just for the convenience of drawing. You may or may not need them, and it all depends upon the type of drawing you are making. Okay, then we have the Artboard Options button. Now let us complete other things first and then we'll come back to this. Next to it, we have Reference Point button. Now this point is linked with Move and Resize options. This point let us choose a particular point of the artboard and apply changes related to moving and resizing with respect to that point. We'll be doing an example of it to understand it better just in a while. Then we have X and Y coordinates. Now, mathematically speaking, this is how the position of anything is located. The horizontal scale is called the x-axis, and the vertical scale is called the y-axis. This red dot is located at coordinates x2 and y3. Similarly, these x and y values are showing the location of the artboard. To have a view of rulers, go to the view menu and select rulers, and here select the show rulers. Now, if you experiment with the reference points, you will see that if you select upper left reference point, which means you are referring the upper left corner of the selected artboard, the x and y values will set according to the position of that point on the ruler. And if I enter x and y values to be 36 points, notice that it will move the artboard in such a way that my upper left corner point, which was my reference point to, is set to 36 on x and y scale. Try changing the reference point and notice the change in the values of x and y. You can experiment it by yourself. And then we have width and height. It represents the width and height values of the artboard. You can set your desired values here also. The reference point has more relevance here if you try to change height or width. Selecting reference point will precisely mean here that selected reference point will stay constant and any change you make will affect the rest of the part of the artboard. Say, if I want to increase the width of the artboard by 200 points and if I select center reference point, that will mean that center point is gonna be constant. An increase of 200 points will be done on the left side and the right side of the artboard equally. You can check the position of the artboard before and after the change of width on the ruler. But if you select, let's say, the upper left corner, then that point of the artboard is going to be constant, and the increment of 200 points will be on the right side only. Here also, you can check the position of the artboard before and after the change. I hope the topic of reference point is pretty much clear to you now, and if it is not yet, don't worry. We'll be experimenting and exploring these reference points in much greater detail in future when I'll teach you the topic of transformation. Then we have the option of constrained proportion. This is a small button between width and height columns, which is called the constraint proportion button. You will see this button in many places all around the Illustrator. What it does is that it maintains a fixed proportion between the height and width when this button is turned on. For example, if you turn this button on when the width and the height values were, let's say, 300 and 200 respectively, and it will then constrain this proportion. In this case, the ratio of 3:2 will be maintained. And if you change any of the values, the other value will get changed as per the set ratio. Say, now you enter 600 in the width column. The height will automatically change to 400, thereby maintaining the ratio of 3:2. At last, it is showing the number of artboards in the document. And now we come back to the Artboard Options button. So, here's the one-liner. All the things which you can do for editing artboard with the buttons appearing in the control panel can be done here also in the dialog box, which appears when we press this button. Additionally, there are two more options which are not there in the control panel under the heading of Global. Now, Global means that this setting will be a global setting for all the artboards, whereas all other settings are applied only to the selected artboard. Let's discuss the two options. The first option is Fade Region Outside the Artboard. Now, this option means that when you are in artboard editing mode, the region outside the artboard, that is the canvas, will appear fade. When you untick this option, you can see that the canvas area is purely white, and at times it is difficult to catch the artboard. This option must be ticked so that we can have a clear vision of our artboard with contrast to the canvas behind. Notice that this option of fading canvas is effective only when you are in artboard editing mode. Otherwise, the canvas has its own solid color. Second option is update while dragging. When this option is ticked, you will notice that whenever you try to drag your artboard to a new place, a translucent appearance of artboard gets shown at a new place. This translucent appearance is not shown when this option is unticked, like this. Always tick this option too for the convenience of your work. To get out of the artboard editing mode, press Escape key. Before I end up this video, I should tell you the other ways to enter in artboard editing mode. Firstly, there is a button in the Tools panel called the Artboard Tool. Secondly, when nothing is selected in your artboard, the Document Setup button gets appeared up on the control panel. Press it to open the Document Setup dialog box, and there, press the Edit Artboards button. So this was the introduction to the artboard. There is a lot of other stuff to know about the artboards, which you are gonna get in the upcoming lessons. Thanks for watching NAC Graphics, and stay tuned.